You know, in the last quarter, you had talked about customers seeking some discounts and project deferrals because of the COVID situation. What is the update on that? I mean, have things improved? Has demand picked up?
Good morning, everyone. Absolutely, the demand has picked up. I think about 70% of all the discounts or the project deferrals that we made during the pandemic time, that has come back already. There is residual 30-40% that is there, which I believe would come back in this quarter because this is the quarter one for most of our clients, and they have new budgets. So that means that they will restart the project that they stopped in the previous year.
So, but what accounted for this fall in the deal pipeline? And it's fallen from 273.9 crores to, sorry, million dollars to $109 million. It's a rather steep fall, sir.
But I don't think that we should look at this as a steep fall, because I have always maintained that if we are able to keep our deal wins above $100 million, it is good. Some of the quarters will be far, far better than the others because we closed a large deal in the previous quarter, and the revenue for those will continue to come in the next 3 years. So I do not think that the deals have gone down. Moreover, the quarter three for IT industry is generally a slow quarter because of the lesser number of days and our clients going through their budget cycle. So it always is that
Mr. Kapoor, this is not washing, sir. Your Q3 FY20 is $362 million.
Because
So,
of
I mean,
one
this
very
looks
large
like
deal
a
that we
this
signed up.
definitely looks, and you know, all the IT companies we've been speaking with are telling us that the deal pipeline is bursting. We feel it will tear the kind of deals we are getting. So, I mean, why was this such a serious one-off for you, and what can you guide on fourth quarter?
No, so I personally do not think that it is a fall for us because there are significant amount of wins that we had even in the quarter three. If we compare it with the previous quarter, there was a large deal. If we compare it with the same quarter previous year, we had closed one Invacare deal because of which it looks very, very high. There will always be certain quarters where there will be a large deal win that will happen. We are working on further large deals. And if we close another one in the quarter four, it will again jump up very, very soon. And this is pretty consistent across the IT industry that some of the quarters may not be as great as the other quarters because of the one-time wins that happen in those quarters.
So what is the revenue visibility that you have for FY22? What could the ballpark growth rates look like?
So we will definitely grow from the previous year. I can only give the guidance up to that level. We definitely are on the growth path, and our quarter four is also looking good. So we will be delivering better than what we delivered in the previous year.
Okay, and this you can keep this kind of margin? 16.5 is what you've reported, 16.4.
That is right. These margins are very, very sustainable. I have always committed to the market that I will continue to deliver consistently more than 15%. Because we are a small company and we also have taken the goal that in the next 4 years we have to become a billion-dollar company. So keeping that in mind, there are certain investments that we'll continue to make. Barring that, our margins are going to be very, very consistent and I'll continue to deliver more than 15%. If we do not make any investments in that quarter, of course, the margins will be far higher. For example, what we saw in this quarter, it is 16.4% and it is very, very sustainable.
Could it get worse in Europe because of the COVID situation? I mean, in any case, for the last 2 quarters, your business from Europe has been slowing down a lot. Do you think it could get worse?
Yeah, it is a bit unpredictable even now because I think we are working well with our existing clients, but it is the net new deals that have slowed down in Europe because there are newer conversations that are required for newer projects to come up. So from that perspective, it is going to remain unpredictable for another 1 quarter, in my opinion.